Every day at Sparrow, we come together with a very focused agenda to plan the best cancer treatment for our patients. We review all of the details. It's a unique approach. Sparrow brings this collaborative process to all of our patients. I'm prepared to tell my patient, this is the plan, before I walk through the door, and know that it's the recommendation of our entire team.
You want to start?
Well, I probably ought to tell the story because I'd tell it better than she would. But we met at the University of Tennessee in Knoxville, and when we were both in college at that time.
At one point when you were younger, you thought maybe you would go into the priesthood.
Oh, yeah, but that was a fleeting thing.
Yes, right.
At first, I wasn't sure about him because he had been dating a girl that I knew.
I started working in the drugstore at the age of 8.
But, I mean, it got to the point where Mr. Mitchell would go on a fishing trip and Jim would be the pharmacist.
We were involved in campus politics in those days, and so she controlled a group that had a large number of votes, and so I set out to court her to get the votes and ended up getting her instead of the votes.
I grew up in a small little town of 800, and the biggest cheese in the town was the doctor. By the end of my career at the drugstore, I had decided that I wanted to be the doctor writing the prescriptions.
Then as I got to know him a little better, I liked him a lot. He was politically savvy.
We were coming from the hoity-toity town of Toronto, and we were sophisticates. So when we first came here, we were only going to stay like 2 or 3 years because we thought, yeah. Lansing, you know, come on, give me a break.
You know, fortunately, Judy followed me a lot of places, so Lansing was along the trail. I don't think any of us ever thought maybe it was the end of the trail and we'd stay here for another 30 years.
You had a vision for what you wanted for the cancer center, and that's been your goal just all along. And so I think it's like you get a little bit, and you stay because maybe you're going to get a little bit more the next year. Maybe you're going to set up a multidisciplinary clinic the next year, you know, and it just keeps you going.
So
pretty soon, it's like, how many years has that been?
We started Neogen Corporation here in Michigan. 40% of our income comes from outside the United States, but we want Lansing to be a better place for our employees to live, and good medical facilities is such an important part of that.
Jim loves what he does. He loves it, and he's dedicated his life to cancer.
Yeah, and weird.
The big thing that's so important about having our own cancer center is the fact that people can have the confidence to go there, get all the treatment that they need, and still be close enough to go sleep in their own bed each night.
The cancer center we have presently has been there since we came, right, Susan?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it used to be a small little radiation therapy department, and now the programs are quite extensive at the cancer center, but we're landlocked and we have no space. You know, cancer is like 1 in 3. So in this room, you guys could be the ones. And so it's always astonishing how many patients there are. So Sparrow now sees about 2,000 patients with cancer a year. So that's what the new cancer center means. It means that we're able to take the vision of a high-class community cancer center in a very nice setting.
The process is we've now gotten accustomed to the fact that there is going to be new technology. And, you know, we all know of people who had cancer that died. They wouldn't die today, you know, when you think about all of the cures that we've had. And I think, you know, we look at it and I think we're just going to see a continuation of that.
And I don't see why cancer patients shouldn't deserve that kind of space. And now we're going to get that space.
I don't remember what scripture of the Bible it is, and I probably won't do it right, but it says, for he who is much is given, much is expected. And, you know, much has been given to us. So this is one of the ways that we can add back to make this a better place.
We believe in what we've been doing, and everybody wants this to happen. So we're just part of that wave, I think, of it finally happening in this town. We've been lucky and fortunate in our lives, and we're able to give back to the community. So we just think this is another aspect of that.